गुरु, हु शुड बी अ गुरु और हु इज क्वालिफाइड टू बी अ गुरु एंड हाउ कैन वी फाइंड अ गुरु, वॉट डू वी डू वेन वी शुड वी गेट अ गुरु, हाउ शुड वी लर्न फ्रॉम अ गुरु, ऑल दीज थिंग्स वी विल ट्राई टू डिस्कस. Now who is
Maharaj, one more thing. What will be the student's qualification also?
Okay.
student's qualification and also what is the meaning of the word guru? Guru, the word meaning is dispeller of darkness, remover of darkness. Guru, that means removal of a person who removes ignorance, that person is guru. And that person removes ignorance, it can be at two levels. It can be at the level of it can be at the level of empirical studies or material studies, and it can be at the level of spirituality, spiritual wisdom. Today we will be concentrating on spiritual gurus, spiritual teacher. Also, guru, one thing which goes without saying is guru is supposed to know what that guru will teach, what that guru is supposed to teach. That one is supposed to know. So in the case of spiritual teacher, guru is supposed to have realized God or realized the truth. Unless guru has realized the truth, the guru has no business talking about the ultimate reality. So I am so totally disqualified to talk about the ultimate reality because I am totally clueless about that. So today we will end the conversation here. What do you say? Because I cannot.
No, at least you can show us the path. At least you know
No,
what
that's
should be the
what. A
course.
guru is one who has already traveled the path and then only can show the path. So I am also in the path. So we are all in footpath now. So how can we show? So, but Yatishwaran ji says, yeah, Swami Yatishwaran ji says that a person who is in fifth class can teach, or a person who is in 10th class can teach a person who is in fifth class, fifth standard. So something like that. I am not in 10th class or something. Whatever I have learned from the scriptures or from great people, realized souls, all those things I can share with you and also recollect for myself. Guru is a person who is established in the truth which that person wants to teach or wants other people or the student to understand. So first, if you have gone to Delhi, only then will you be able to tell others, guide others how to go to Delhi. That is the basic thing. The guru should be first a knower of truth. And a guru should be one who should not make a business of teaching spirituality. Because if somebody is making a business of teaching spirituality, that means that that person is attached to material comforts. And anybody who has realized the ultimate truth cannot be attached to material comforts. It is simply impossible. Because what is the ultimate truth? That you are not the body and the mind. So, if someone has realized that truth, if someone has come to that particular realization, then it is automatic that that person will not give time for one's body and mind, or that person will not go behind sensory enjoyments. And if you see somebody who is indulged in sense enjoyments, then it is quite evident that that person is not qualified to be a spiritual teacher or a guru. The other thing is that whether this guru is talking something in line with what great masters across centuries, across world religions have said. For example, if a guru comes and tells you that you should not speak truth, there is no point in speaking truth. Why do you take all the pressure? Just tell whatever you feel like. Whenever you want to feel tell the truth, tell the truth. Whenever you want to tell lies, tell the lies. And don't worry. After all, you are Atman. You are above truth and lies. If someone says like this, that means this person is seriously wrong. There is some serious wrong understanding of this person. And this person cannot be followed. Shankaracharya in one of his commentaries says that if you see a person who is not following the tradition, in the sense of the tradition of the realized souls, tradition of great masters, then just give up that person, just like you would ignore a donkey. So like a donkey, you just ignore that person. That person is equivalent to a donkey. And then also, if this person may not be openly enjoying sense pleasures, but may be making an exhibition of one's knowledge or one's saintliness, that person also should not be followed. That person is also not guru. Why? Because any external thing in name and form is something which is not our true personality, which is not in the nature of the self or Atman. And so if a person is sitting in the middle of the road and trying to meditate there, showing to other people that the person is meditating, you should not believe such a person. Sri Ramakrishna says that people who wear wooden sandals, put lot of malas and carry this kamandalu and all that, most of them you should not believe. Why? These things they are making, they are doing for a show. And so what happens? If Ramakrishna Mission monks come out, people don't even bother. Because clean shaven, well dressed, neatly dressed and all this. No, you should be either naked, you should have so much of bhasma on your body, or you should have jata, you should have hair which is unkempt, and then you should have some trishul, etc. So whatever is photographic, whatever is nice to be caught in the photo camera, that is considered spirituality. That is the general idea of spirituality. People, Mahatmaji means there will be so many malas in the neck, etc. And there will be dadi and must all these things, huge dadi. The longer the beard of a sadhu, the more the followers. So that is the idea. So the length, you can actually see the number of followers is directly proportional to the length of the beard of a monk. Now that doesn't happen. So in Ramakrishna Mission or other sadhus, they are not bothered to show whether they are spiritual or not to people. And this is one way where you can judge. And the best method to judge is whether the person who is practicing or who is claiming to have practiced spirituality and have understood truth, who is your guru, who is your spiritual teacher, whether that person himself or herself is practicing what she or he says, whether they themselves do it. Sri Ramakrishna very famously said in Bengali, Dine dekbi, ratre dekbi. You should check a guru in daytime and also in the night time. You have to constantly be checking the guru. Because guru, a person who has taught you or who is teaching you physics, chemistry or biology, that person is giving you some information. That person is telling you certain things. And it is sufficient if the person is skillful or efficient in that particular field of study. But if a person is trying to teach you spirituality, that person is not just giving you some information, but that person is trying to give you the ultimate truth or show you the path to ultimate truth. And so it is very important that that person also has that knowledge. And in spiritual teaching, a part of the guru is transmitted to the student. And so the character of the guru is very important. What is the character? Character means whether the guru does what he says or she says, or the word, deed and action, word, deed and thought, all these things are aligned on the same direction. And the guru thinks of oneself not as body and mind, but as Atman, as soul. If these things are there, then and only then we can have a guru. Now the next question is, how do we find a guru? And the old, old adage, when the student is ready, teacher arrives, is true. When you really want spiritual wisdom, you will definitely get the guru. Most of the times, it is just some monkey renunciation or Markata Vairagya that you did not get good breakfast in the morning, you had to eat only mango and banana. So, you suddenly feel that the world is so bad and why am I living, etc. Such existential questions pop up. Why? They pop up because you don't get things to satisfy your senses. But if you get those things, then immediately your renunciation, your dispassion goes away. Then you are no more bothered about the temporary nature of this world. You are no more bothered about the fact that this world is not permanent. This is called monkey renunciation. In Sanskrit, Markata Vairagya. Markata means monkey. Vairagya, dispassion or renunciation. So, that kind of renunciation if you have, you will never get the teacher. Most of the people say that nowadays we get such teachers, such people who say that you enjoy the senses and you will get God also. So, they are not good. We get fake gurus, etc. True. Why are you getting fake gurus more and more today? Because you want them. Because people want to listen, somebody say that, yes, you enjoy your senses and yet you can have a spiritual life. So it is, you have a win-win situation. You want best of both the worlds. So that is why you want that. So there are people. You see, demand and supply. Simple economics, right? And you have demand, so the people come there and they see this opportunity and they start supplying. But if you truly want spiritual wisdom, if you truly want, why should we come to religion? Why do we come to religion? Or why do we need to come to religion or spirituality? Because we want to get rid of suffering. That is why we want to come to spirituality. Now, if you truly need to get rid of suffering, then we can get good guru or true teacher, true spiritual teacher. In Sanskrit, it is called Atyantika Dukkha Nivritti, suffering. All kinds of suffering, that is suffering caused by your mind and body, suffering caused by other living beings, and suffering caused by divine elements. So if you want to get rid of all these sufferings, all kinds of suffering, then you need to come to spirituality. And when you will have such yearning, such pain, that I should get rid of suffering, then you will definitely find a guru. This is the idea. And once you find the guru, what to do? That is again, till you get a job, good job. People say, I want to get a job, good job, etc. They get a job. finally they don't know what to do. Or in IITs, they whole life almost they are practicing since childhood. Oh, I want to get, etc. Into IIT. But then when they come into IIT, they say, now what to do? We don't know. Now you have to study, but people think that IIT, once you arrived at IIT, it is the destination. But it is not the destination, it is the beginning. Similarly, when you get a guru, till then you will say, ah, if I get a guru, then this suffering will be end, come to an end, etc., etc. Then the guru says, no, 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 suffering will not come to an end like that. You have to do these spiritual practices. Then he says, oh, spiritual practices. Yes, you will have to meditate. Oh, how much should I meditate? No, 1 hour in the morning and 1 hour in the evening to begin with. So to begin with, can I not meditate for 20 minutes? So no, 20 minutes, then you have to go to some other person. But if you want to realize ultimate reality, then you have to give more time. So, oh, that is the problem. Then I cannot give up the job. I cannot give up family work. How can I suddenly go, etc., etc. This is one minute. There is a person who is joining us from US of A. Okay. So, 1 second.
Murad, just drag his ID to our call.
Yeah. So, when we get a guru, first thing we need to do is we need to approach the guru and approach the guru with respect and also ask questions which are important. So, most of the people get a guru, but they ask questions like, Maharaj, what did you have for breakfast? Okay, I had this for breakfast. Oh, Maharaj, when did do you get up? Okay, I get up at this time. Oh, Maharaj, what you wear only this kind of dress, same dress you wear. These are the wonderful questions people ask. They don't ask about other things. That is why in Gita it is told, Pariprashnena Sevaya. You have to serve the teachers, Tattva Darshinaha, Tattva Darshibihi, people who have seen the truth, who have realized the truth, those people you have to serve them, and also you have to ask them questions. Pariprashna. You have to ask them proper questions. That is what. And then they upadekshanti te jnanam. Jnaninaha tattva darshini. So they will then give you the knowledge of spiritual wisdom. They will give you spiritual wisdom. Unless you ask them the question, they will not give you. How can they give you? So, even when you get the guru, what questions to ask the guru? That is very important. How to approach the guru and how to serve the guru. Serving not according to what you want. The people have this guru in eastern part of India. This guru tradition is, family guru tradition is very much in practice. And every family will have a guru. And they will take initiation from the guru and they will do. Now when the family guru comes to the house, that's all. That person's all metabolic system will be in danger. Why? Because all these people will try to feed him whatever, what not. They will feed everything. They will make in one day and they will feed everything the guru. And by that time the guru is going to leave the house. Either he is going to have cholesterol problems, or he is going to have dysentery problems, either one of them, and indigestion and all that. And then they say, oh, we have served our guru so much. We have not like that, not what you want to give the guru, but what actually the guru wants. That is the kind of service we should do. That is what we have to do. Now, that kind of service we don't do. We do service according to how we want to serve the guru.
I have some that kind of example in my family also. Like
Yeah.
my mausi, yeah. So my mo I saw like my I don't know maternal uncle, not my mausi. And okay, so they used to worship one guru. I saw in their photo, yes, photo. They used to do the agarbatti and all those stuff. And then one day he came in their house, and I didn't recognize him. Who is that guy? He's a big belly, like Gusai, and he is talking to my mouse and all for something, and they feed him like very well, and he went away. And then I asked, who is this guy? Then my aunt says, like, he's our like Kula Guru. I said, oh my God, this is our guru. That's it.
No, that is okay because that was, they were served like that, so they have become like that.
But there should not be that much fatty, na? Guru should not be that much fatty.
No, that is okay because of sedentary lifestyle, maybe they become like that. That is a different question altogether. But what I am telling is how you should serve the guru. You should give them not what you want to give them, but what they actually need. That is what you need to give them. So now these are the basic things, and also when the guru says something, you have to follow it. You have to just not think anything and just follow what the guru says. If you have come to a guru, then constantly if you keep on doubting, that may not lead you to a great, the basic faith you should have on the guru. Now, I request all of you to bring up different ideas, whatever you have in your mind. Let us brainstorm about having a guru, qualifications of a guru, and whether we should need the guru. That is again a question. And also how to live with a guru, how to approach a guru, what to serve the guru, how to serve the guru, etc. Yes. Byomkesh.
Maharaj, first of all, like I would like to say, when you said like if we have the real yearning for guru, then we'll get it. So that means we are not we none of I don't say none of us, like most of us did not qualify in that level, or our yearning not that much that we can get a guru.
Why you are not initiated as yet?
No, I'm not initiated as of now, but I'm thinking, like I'm also thinking to get a guru, but I was I did not get such like such person as of now as a spiritual guru.
No, there are people, you are wasting your time not getting initiated. So you, there are people, definitely there are people. So you don't waste time and get initiated. Go to a guru. So you, some effort also we have to put. It is true that the student is ready, then guru will come. But you have to also search. It is not that you will simply means wait indefinitely. That is also true.
All right.
And when you have, when you don't have a guru, then you will have a problem. So now we have Kavita Lakshmi from US. She is actually a scientist and she has joined this Good Morning Kavita. From India, it is good morning. For you, it is good evening or good night. So she has joined this discussion on Guru. Okay.
Can one have multiple gurus?
Multiple gurus, it's a good question. Multiple, as far as we are talking only of spirituality, so in spirituality you can have only one guru who will be your spiritual guru, a person who has given you the mantra and also who is teaching you how to go in the spiritual path. But there are different types of gurus in spiritual life also. Like there is this guru who is helping you in reading the scriptures. There is the another guru who is helping in maybe setting right your routine when you get up and when you go to sleep, etc., etc., and all those basic mundane details of our life. That kind of guru. There may be a guru who does that. And that's it. So you have different types of gurus in spiritual life, but the ultimate guru, the guru who has given you mantra or the spiritual knowledge or shows you the path of spiritual discipline, that person has to be one. Otherwise, there will be a lot of confusion. All these other gurus, suppose you want to study Gita and you get a guru, that person is also in a way spiritual guru, but not a person who has given you mantra. So he is an acharya. He is a different person. And also you, there could be a guru who may help you with rituals, like going on pilgrimages or doing certain kind of rituals, when to do what, puja, etc. For that also you can have a guru. But that guru again is not the person who will be taking care of your spiritual path or spiritual discipline.
Okay.
And what happens when the guru is not in the mortal body?
Guru, yeah, that again is a good question. Because in many traditions, like the Ramakrishna Math, Ramakrishna order, guru gives you mantra diksha, gives you spiritual initiation, and then after some time you see the guru is old and has left the body. But then the guru has given you different instructions, and probably those instructions are also there in the form of books or in the form of a legacy which is carried forward. For example, in the Ramakrishna order, the legacy of guru is actually the legacy of Sri Ramakrishna. And Sri Ramakrishna's teaching and Swami Vivekananda's teachings and Sri Sarada Devi's teachings are carried forward and propagated by different gurus over a period of time. Now, these gurus give you those instructions and tell you what books to read and what method to follow. That is what you have to do. And now, in such traditions, there is something called Guru Sthana or Guru Pitha, like in Ramakrishna order, it is Belur Math. So the guru, the lineage of the guru or the tradition of the guru over a period of time, they will have different people who are given the charge or the responsibility of taking care of spiritual seekers. So if you have any doubt, you can go and ask them. Maybe your guru is not in in the body or he is not alive. But definitely you can go and ask other people who are there. Whose phone is that?
Sorry, it's my phone.
Okay, thank God. I thought you don't have a voice. You have a voice. Wow. Okay.
No, you were all in the middle of a discussion, so I just thought, let me...
No, we greeted you. We said good morning or good evening. Okay, so again we greet you. Welcome to the group.
Oh, thank you, and namaste to all of you.
Okay, and we have we have Vandana from Dehradun. We have Anna from Canada. We have Shubhadeep and Ajit from Kanpur. We have Byomkesh Das and his better half Papiya Das from Pune. We have Avinash from Kanpur. Avinash, is there anybody else with you? Avinash? ओके अविनाश हिमसेल्फ इज नॉट देयर, देन वी हैव कपिल फ्रॉम पुणे. कपिल आपके साथ और कोई है क्या? कपिल
हेलो,
आपके साथ कोई और है क्या?
नो नो महाराज.
कपिल, सो कपिल फ्रॉम पुणे. सो सो वी आर नाउ डिस्कसिंग अबाउट गुरु. ओके सो दिस इज
या आई गॉट दैट. तो राकार स्वामी ब्रह्मानंद जी सेज दैट यू नो योर हार्ट इज बाय सेल्फ गुरु और समथिंग लाइक दैट राइट.
हूज माइक्रोफोन इज डिस्टर्बिंग हियर? Hello.
I have no idea. It's not mine.
Okay. Yeah. So what Swami Brahmanji said?
Swami Brahmanandaji says that your heart is your guru or something like that, right?
No, your heart. No, that Sri Ramakrishna says that your Brahmanandaji repeats that Sri Ramakrishna says that pure mind is guru. So if your mind has become pure. Pure means just not the kind of idea of purity we have. Pure means where there are no desires. If your mind has no desires, then your mind itself will act as a guru. No desire means completely no desires. There should be not even an iota of desire. Then it will act as a guru.
But so, like, what's the difference between the morality or the consciousness which tells us, okay, this is right, this is wrong, and then where is the line between the consciousness which says us, okay, you go in this way, because we cannot depend on the guru for everything in life, right? I don't know, I just joined very lately and so on, what topic of the guru you are all discussing, but this is something I always feel that in those days we had a guru who can always have a close contact with whatever dealings we have in life and all those stuff. But now we are all living in such a
you see, this is a big misconception. This is a big misconception people have, that I should constantly talk to the guru. And that is what I was telling, that what should you talk to the guru about? What should you talk the with the guru about? Most of the people talk to the guru, they say, oh, what are you having in for breakfast, oh, when did you go there, etc. That is what, please let me complete. That is what people are talking about. That is what people are talking about. Okay. So if we are talking about spiritual wisdom, then you actually don't need to talk to the guru so often. And also the guru has given you instructions. Even if you don't, if you are unable to stay with the guru, or you are unable to call the guru whenever you want, or talk to the guru whenever you want, even then, though that is not taking place, guru has given you the instructions, and what you have to do is you have to just follow them. And if you follow them, you will get some light, or you will get some progress, and you can know that there will be some kind of sign of your progress. And that is what we have to do. You see, most of the people say that we need to talk to the guru and all that, but we do not have any capability to talk to the guru, because we are not going to say, like, guru, today I was in samadhi, so you see, now I was in sampragyata samadhi, so I just want to go to asampragyata samadhi. How many people do you think will talk to the guru like that? No, very few, or almost nil. But most of us talk like, ah, Maharaj, how are you? How is your health? Yes, I just want your blessing. Please bless me. So guru has already given you initiation, means he has already blessed you, or she has already blessed you. What we need to do now is to practice. But most of the times what we see in real life is that people come to the guru and hardly does anybody actually talk about spirituality. And so there was a spiritual disciple, there was a spiritual aspirant whose name was Sri Ramakrishna. And he, whenever he had a guru, he asked questions. He asked those right questions. He said, now this is the experience I am going through. What is this experience all about? Please enlighten me. Please tell me. Then this is the experience I am getting. Now tell me what I should do. That was the correct disciple. And so he got wonderful gurus. Whenever he was doing whatever spiritual practice, he got the gurus. When he wanted to practice Vedanta, Advaita Vedanta, he got Totapuri. When he wanted to practice Tantra, he got Bhairavi Brahmani. So he got extraordinary gurus. Though there is a divine element, there is a supranatural element, but still he got them because he was actually practicing. So most of us, we don't even deserve the company of a guru because we have nothing to take advantage of from that company. So this whole idea that we should live together or Gurukula Vasa, which is called, Kula means the family and Guru means Guru. So with the family of the Guru, we don't really need. In fact, I think that it is better that we don't live with the family of the Guru or with the Guru, because otherwise that poor person will have no peace of mind, you see. So that is good. That is good. So at least give that person some time and let that person be having some spiritual time for oneself. So this is one thing. So Guru is for spiritual practice, and that is why again in that Bhagavad Gita shloka it is told, Pariprashnena Sevaya. So through asking questions and through service. Vandana ji, aap Guru ke bare mein kya soch rahe hain?
महाराज, मेरे माइंड में एक क्वेश्चन है कि मतलब कैसे पता लगेगा कि वी हैव फाइंड द राइट गुरु?
फर्स्ट थिंग इज आई थिंक आई टोल्ड यू दोस थिंग्स अर्लियर इटसेल्फ, बट स्टिल आई विल टेल अगेन. फर्स्ट थिंग इज दैट पर्सन शुड नॉट हैव एनी अटैचमेंट टू सेंस एंजॉयमेंट. सेकंड, दैट पर्सन शुड नॉट मेक अ शो ऑफ वन स्पिरिचुअल अकम्प्लिशमेंट. थर्ड इज दैट पर्सन शुड प्रैक्टिस वॉट he or she preaches. These three things you see, then you will understand that this is a guru. And there should be no doubt in that person's mind about God or about the spiritual realization. Vandana?
Hanji Maharaj. Maharaj, how do we know? We can't say with a guru or we don't have enough contact nahi hai when we are going that for the just for a while we are meeting, then how we can say that he has a he or she is good for us
when you are going, when you are meeting, when you are meeting. If you have you read Sherlock Holmes,
no Maharaj. No.
So when you read Sherlock Holmes, there is this now and then that Dr. Watson asks him, the detective, that what, how could he find out? So he says, elementary, dear Watson, it's so elementary. Then he says that this person did that, etc. By observing a person, he can tell everything. So similarly, by observation, observing the guru, you can tell so many things about the guru. When you are going to meet a person, you can see where that person stays. Not to the person's bedroom, but wherever you are meeting the person, you can see. It is so evident. And then you can ask the person some pointed questions, specific questions. Then you will come to know about the person's true opinion, you see. That all that you will have to do.
Maharaj, okay, go.
Maharaj, I have a question. So, what if I want to have a guru, my spiritual guru, but I am not really interested in having a mantra diksha or something like that, the way that is done in Ramakrishna Math or anywhere else, like taking a mantra from guru and then, you know, kind of using that in your prayers and all. So what if I don't do that and then you know, but I still have a guru and have spiritual talk or follow his instructions like that. Is that okay? Or is it something that we should be having, or we have to have a mantra as well from guru?
There can be two situations, two answers to this question, and I will give you both the answers. I will give the first, I will tell you this. If you have seen somebody and you think that this person should be my guru, and presently, if you go to that person and ask for some mantra and that person is unable to give you mantra, so you think that, okay, I want this person only as my guru. So even if he does not give mantra or she does not give mantra, it's okay. Is that the kind of situation you are in now, right now?
Yes. Yeah, that is also one thing, and the other thing is might be I don't get the feeling of or have the need of getting a mantra. It's like
No,
I don't
if
know
you see, if this is the situation, if the first situation is the situation which many people are there, I know, they see a person and they want to make that person guru, but for many reasons that person says, no, no, I will not give you mantra. For example, Ramana Maharshi never gave any mantra or anything. So people loved him, loved the way he taught. So they went to him and said no. So Ramana Maharshi taught them a way and they live. But it is very difficult to live in that way. The way of Ramana Maharshi is very difficult. It is not for everyone. And so Ramana Maharshi also advised many people to go to different people and take initiation, take mantra. You see, so the best thing when you are in such a situation, when you want to make somebody your guru, but for various reasons that person cannot give you mantra, then go and ask that person himself or herself whether you should take mantra or not. And now we come to the main question or the bigger question, should we have a mantra? Why don't I just have a guide and all that? So, Poppy, I believe you are into Java programming.
Yes.
Yeah, so Java programming, when you learn, you go to a institute or a college, etc. And then you tell the teacher, madam, I want to learn Java programming, but you see the command for this should be this. Do you do like that?
No.
What? Do you do like that? No, you don't.
No.
You don't write the syntax. The syntax has been already written. You just study it. Similarly, in spiritual life, you are not the person who dictates to the guru. Guru, okay, you give me spiritual instruction, but I don't want mantra. You see, it is problematic. I don't want mantra. I don't want to get up early in the morning. Oh, it is problematic. And then, no, I want to be like that. I want to enjoy life also. Otherwise, how it will be? It will be problematic. So you tell all those things what to do. Then why do you want a guru in the first place? So when you go to a guru, just surrender. Just follow what the guru says. If the guru says that you have to practice a mantra, practice it. And you are telling, I don't feel. You don't feel, right? And you are not getting any getting rid of suffering. You are not being free of suffering. So that means whatever you feel or whatever you think of spiritual life is all wrong. Right? Right now your idea of spiritual life and the world and your own self is wrong. So now you just go and surrender to guru. That's all.
Maharaj,
one more. We are not doing shopping. It is not spirituality shopping. Like you go to rediff.com and then say, okay, where is the guru? Okay, guru. Okay, latest release, new release guru. Okay, now this offer guru is there. Okay, purchase now and shipping free. Like that. No, it is not like that. We are not on a shopping of guru. Guru, out of guru's grace, gives us wisdom. Yes, Byomkesh, what were you telling?
Yes. If someone likes Vivekananda or Sarvama or Ramana Maharshi or some spiritual guru as a guru who are not in mortal body, so will it be fine? Or what will be the problem?
We can quote Ramana Maharshi to prove that we don't need a guru. We can quote Ekalavya to say that we don't need to actually meet a guru. But please remember again and again that Ramana Maharshi and Ekalavya are not the norm. They are exceptions. So let us not go by the exceptions. Let us go by the norm. Okay. You have studied engineering. For studying one engineering course, you needed so many teachers, not one teacher. So many teachers, like 10-15 teachers came and taught you. That is a mundane material knowledge, empirical knowledge. So what do you think? For learning this empirical knowledge, you needed so many teachers. Do you think spiritual knowledge will come so easily without any teacher?
No.
It is totally foolish and stupid to think like that. Why do we then always want that, no, without guru I can do? Array, people are not clear about structural engineering. There are 1,000 opinions about the structural strength of concrete. on a such a small trivial issue there is so many opinion difference of opinion, so much. How can people be clear about something, how they are unclear about something which is so concrete as concrete itself? How can be people clear about something which is totally we are clueless about, like Atman? How can we be clear? So we need a guru who has realized Atman. There is no doubt about it.
All right, thanks.
Anna, are you there?
Yes, I am here.
Oh, there was no audio input. So, have you anything to add or subtract or divide or multiply?
No, I just noticed, from the few stories that I've heard, that very often, when one meets the guru, it's sometimes there is like resistance and doubt, I guess.
Yes.
So is that like the normal?
Yeah, it is normal. Doubt is normal. Doubt is normal, and guru, our surrender or our faith in guru would itself slowly help us to come out of the doubt. You see, what we have to do is we have to not let our hold on guru go away. We have to catch on to the guru, like firmly grasp on to guru. That is what we have to do. So, they say, like Tulasidas says, that you see, guru is more important, because God, what God has done, God has given me ignorance and put me into this world of delusion, Maya. God has created this confusion for me, but it is guru who is taking me out of this confusion. So guru is greater than God. I am not saying this, Tulasidas is saying this.
And sometimes when I think it happened also a few times that like the disciple dies, the student outgrows the guru.
Anna, it may have happened in some great people's lives, but it will, or in normal situation, it will happen only if the guru is not capable. If the guru is not true guru, then that will happen. But otherwise, if you have gone to a true guru, you can never outgrow your guru. It's simply not possible. That happened only in the case of Sri Ramakrishna or like that. You know, incarnations or avatars, but not in normal human beings' case. Why does that happen? Because we have gone to a wrong guru in the first place. Something that guru is telling is wrong. And so when we realize that, then we think, "Arey, this person is telling something wrong." So we think that we have outgrown. But we have not outgrown. We have only understood that this guru is false. कपिल जी बहुत शांत बैठे हुए हो।
महाराज मैं सिर्फ सुन रहा हूँ, फर्स्ट टाइम मतलब अटेंड कर रहा हूँ ये लेक्चर. सो
ये लेक्चर नहीं है जी, डिस्कशन है।
सॉरी डिस्कशन सर.
अविनाश इज
हेलो
नॉट
महाराज,
कॉल, आप कहाँ चले गए थे? गुमसुम?
कहाँ ही मेरा सर लैपटॉप हैंग हो गया था सर बीच में जब आप बात कर रहे थे. सॉरी सर फॉर दैट.
ओहो, वो कहाँ से लटक रहा था, छत से कि कहाँ से?
ये थोड़ा प्रॉब्लम है सर लैपटॉप सर, ओवर हीट हो रहा है और फिर हैंग हो रहा है.
ओवर हीटिंग, फैन का प्रॉब्लम हो सकता है. सो शुभदीप, एनीथिंग टू ऐड और समथिंग?
सोच ही रहा था.
व्हाट हैपेंड टू पूनम?
She has gone home, right? We do not know if she has come back.
Okay, and what about Ajit? Ajit is also so silent.
Yes, Maharaj, yeah, I'm also listening and I'm trying to learn so many things. So whatever you say and other members also say.
So, if any one of you is remotely interested in spiritual life, you need a guru. Without guru, you cannot even start. So,
Maharaj, I have a small question actually.
small, yeah.
Yes. Yeah, because the kind of life we are in, and we are not too much into the spiritual process, but still we need a guru, as you said, that the guru who dispels the darkness. So as a student, we also have a lot of ignorance, and then we also need a guru who can remove our darkness in the term like what we are pursuing, like for small commitment we are in still academics. So in that term, how do you think, like
Here we were talking about only spiritual guru, but then what you're talking about is a guide or a counselor, etc. That you can have, but then you see that's a totally completely different level altogether. Here we are talking about a spiritual guru, and you might not be into spirituality, but nobody can be totally away from spirituality because that is your nature. So it is better to have a spiritual life, to have some kind of spiritual discipline, because it gives a totally new perspective to the entire life and world and people around us. So I suggest that all of you start some spiritual practice and have a guru. And the goal is to understand your own personality. That if you have, then you can actually get some thing. And in spirituality, as in the Gita, it is told, there is this guarantee that nothing goes waste. So whatever small practice you are doing in this life, that will not go waste. That is not going to go waste. So you will get it. वैसे गुरु के बहुत सारे मतलब हैं. There are different meanings of guru. So I can definitely tell you what is there in the scripture. I can also guide you how you should follow your routine, etc. But I cannot give you a mantra. I cannot give you a mantra right now. And for that you will have to contact. I will guide you there also, from whom you can get a mantra, etc. So that mantra you can get from that particular monk, and then you can practice.
Maharaj, one more question.
Yes.
With regard to like spiritual wisdom, it is possible. I mean, it is true that the disciple will completely agree with the like spiritual instructions given by the guru. But is it necessary that he should have no? There are cases where with reference to some worldly matters, there may be some differences of opinion, right? So
now we are talking here only about spiritual guru. So let us not even talk about worldly matters. That is, for example, Holy Mother Sarada Devi said, "Oh, this girl can key the clock." Those days you had the clock which had to be keyed, the wound. So this girl can do that, so intelligent she is. So this is so simple of mother to say that. Okay, so that kind of thing we don't need to actually bother about. Those things will differ.
Right.
We are not talking about those kinds of mundane matters. We are talking about spiritual matters. In spiritual matters, what the guru says, we have to follow. If you are not able to convince yourself, you can ask the guru questions. But again and again, the guru will answer the same way. And then there is a point where you know that what he is telling is true, but you are not wanting to do it, or your mind is rebelling. At that time, you have to just follow the guru.
I think we have to go to Belur Math to observe Guru for some time. Sorry, I'm just telling.
No, you don't need to go to Belur Math. Actually, you don't need to do. You can go to any of our centers and you can follow the routine and you can see the routine. The same thing is there in most of the centers, or almost all the centers. So you don't need to go to Belur Math to see that. You can just see in any of the centers. You can see any sadhu, any monk, and because the guru will be of a older age, much elderly than the monk whom you will see. So automatically it goes without saying that the guru would have gone through worse hardships than the monk you are seeing. So you can just see anybody and then you can get initiation from the guru. And also when you will meet a guru, you will understand. So any other question? No.
I'm done from my side, John. John, sorry.
Papia? So Vyomkesh, your on-site person is called John, is it?
Yes.
So he says, I am done from my side, John. That was fun.
I'm extremely sorry for that. It's just...
Raj, I have one question.
Yeah.
Maharaj, as you said, ki we never ask question or the reason what the guru is telling us. Every time we should follow this thing?
In spiritual matters, of course.
Okay.
In spiritual matter. If the guru is saying that get up at 4 o'clock, get up at 4 o'clock. If the guru is saying practice this mantra 10,000 times, repeat the mantra 10,000 times. There you don't question. There you don't question. In spiritual matters, and also spiritual matter is all-encompassing, because it is like the guru will say, don't take so much food in the night, then you will not be able to meditate. Or don't eat this type of food, then it will create problem. Don't mix with that type of person, it will affect your mind. So all these things you have to follow.
Okay. And something which as a reasoning kind, some question was like that for this, person
asks question then? See, reasoning again, as I am telling you, that first of all, this gender thing. Nowadays, it's a big thing, okay? Earlier also it was. So when you say that don't talk to a girl, then immediately a boy will say, oh, this Maharaj has no other work. He's just telling me not to talk to the work, a girl. How is it? How does it matter? How does it affect my spiritual life? So it does affect your spiritual life. But people don't realize that, you see? Then they will say, no, let me follow this according to what I think is correct. But that is wrong. So, what is the matter which you think, like you may think that pizza, I can eat lot of pizza. Why should I stop? So, maybe the particular guru is giving you some instruction or is about to tell you something which will be not successful if you eat pizza because it contains lot of cheese. There may be some remote connection. We don't know those things. All you can do is you can ask the guru, then tell me, why are you doing this? Then the guru will tell you, oh, this is because of this, etc., etc. So when the mind is asked to, you know, practice discipline, when the mind is asked to do spiritual exercises, it catches on to whatever it has. Just like a person who is drowning in water, that person will catch on to whatever one can to save oneself. Similarly, mind does. So the mind, if you say that, no, you should not meditate or do spiritual practices with a woman, or for to a woman you say that don't do this with a man, then the mind becomes uncomfortable. Otherwise, what will the mind do? The mind will say, yes, I am doing spiritual practice. Let me do spiritual practice with a same like-minded man, and the woman and man together will be meditating. And what will they meditate upon? They will be meditating on each other, not on the chosen ideal. So these things are very subtle, but we have to follow them. And so that is why again and again I am telling you that guru, whatever the true guru says, that guru, you have to follow that guru.
And Maharaj, to know guru, we must know the we must have the interaction.
Not interaction. For example, if you just get you see an advertisement where it says that pay 10,000 rupees and then you will be taught some spiritual instruction. Then you don't need to go there at all. That is the end of the story. That's all. Finish. So just by this criteria, most of the gurus will be disqualified. Then the second criteria is, does that person make show? That is also another criteria, another Now, if you just follow these two criteria, I think almost 95% of the gurus in the world will be vanished. They will be discovered.
Maharaj, mera interaction se matlab ye tha ki abhi jaise Dehradun mein riksha hui hai, so nobody knows about the Maharaj. और ना ही महाराज को कभी किसी ने इंडक्शन या ना किसी ने उनके साथ कोई बात किया, तो दे ऑल हैड द दीक्षा, बट वो जो भाव आता है या जो श्रद्धा रिस्पेक्ट आती है, दे आर नॉट फाइंडिंग.
आता है भाव, आता है व्हाटएवर रिस्पेक्ट कम्स. हाउ डू यू नो व्हाट रिस्पेक्ट कम्स इफ यू डोंट ऑलरेडी हैव दैट रिस्पेक्ट? हाउ डू यू नो व्हाट रिस्पेक्ट कम्स? एक्चुअली दिस इज अ मिसकंसेप्शन इन आवर माइंड. वी थिंक दैट समथिंग विल कम. नथिंग इज गोइंग टू कम लाइक दैट. Only thing which will come on your top of the head is when you stand under a shower while taking bath. Only water will come. Nothing is going to come. What will come? That is what we have a wrong notion. And another thing, again and again I'm telling you, we are all so much, you know, we enamor that we should talk to Guru. What will you talk? What will you ask the Guru? You have nothing to ask the Guru. You will just talk and say, Maharaj, how are you? Yes, Maharaj. Then next time you meet, you will bring some sweets or you will bring some dress. You will want to serve the Guru, whatever I can give. And it is a big problem because all these Gurus have so many disciples and everyone is bringing sweet and that poor person has diabetes. Now what to do with the sweets? Now that's a big food situation there. And then you bring so many dresses and some dresses are which cannot be worn. People, for example, in Ramakrishna order, we have a way of wearing dresses. So people bring all the dress, like we don't have collars in our shirts and all that. So we wear this Punjabi type shirt, kurta type shirt, and that doesn't have collar. And we don't use that. People with so much love and affection purchase a dress which has got collar, which is of a different color. Who told you to purchase that dress? And the dress will be like costing so bad, so indecently it will be expensive, like some 2000 rupees or something. What is the necessity? So don't do anything which you are not asked to do. Don't serve in the way you want to be served, because that is not what that person wants. That person wants some peace of mind. Most of the time when people come and talk to a guru who is a true guru, who is a spiritual guru, that person will think, when will this man go or this woman go? That is the idea which is there in the mind. Because you're disturbing that person. And do you have any question, spiritual question? If you have a spiritual question, even that guru, the spiritual guru will, even if that person is on the deathbed, will give you an answer. But you don't have a spiritual question. All questions you have is, Maharaj, what food did you take? How are you? How is your health? These are all stupid questions. These are all not spiritual questions. Spiritual question is, Maharaj, now I am doing meditation, this is what I see, and is this okay and or not? You don't have such questions at all. So why do you want to talk to the Guru? What will you talk to? Talk about?
Maharaj, one more thing. Like, will it be possible, like, before take the Diksha, we'll stay on ashrama for some period of time and we'll spend some time with the Guru.
And then?
Then we'll go for Diksha.
What is Diksha?
Diksha means the Mantra Diksha.
Now, what does it mean actually? What is it signifying? What is Mantra Diksha?
I'm starting my spiritual...
So, if you want to start a spiritual journey from a particular tradition, instead of going and staying with that person, just read books about the tradition. What do they think is true? What do they believe in? Read those basic books. Then you will understand, oh, this is what they think. Okay, now whether that is why when in Ramakrishna order, we give initiation. Before that, we ask people to read about Sri Ramakrishna and all that. Are you comfortable in accepting that all religions are true? Are you comfortable in accepting that renunciation is necessary? All these things you read, and then when you are okay, then you take initiation. What will you do staying in an ashrama without reading this? If you just stay in the ashrama, all you will get is good breakfast, lunch and dinner. By that, what will you understand about the tradition in which you are going to get initiated? So that is not the way you should do. What you should do is you should read about the tradition. You should read, you should also see or understand the lives of these great people, and then you decide whether you should be initiated or not. Staying in an ashrama will not help, because we don't have so many guest houses also, and then maybe an ashrama is an ordinary guest house is there. All you will be worried about in the ashrama is that your bathroom, this thing is not working, flush is not working or something like that. That doesn't make sense. In practice, you have to give more time to studying the tradition, to understanding the tradition, then go for initiation. Staying in an ashrama will not help you much.
Got it.
Okay, so it was so nice to have all of you today here on this discussion on guru or spiritual teacher. Okay, so what would be the discussion next week?
Let others decide, Maharaj.
No, I did not ask you. I did not say Byomkesh. I asked everyone. Yeah, it is every week 9 to 10.
9 to 10 on Saturday or Saturday Sunday morning, is it?
Sunday morning, yes.
Okay.
So, any suggestions, Anna, on the next topic?
No suggestions.
Vandana?
No, Maharaj.
Papiya?
Maharaj.
Any suggestions?
No, I'm thinking, Maharaj. I don't have anything in mind right now.
Kavita?
So how many weeks this has been going on?
No. Do you have any suggestion for the next Sunday's topic?
No, that's what I'm asking. So is
Aray, how is it related? How many weeks it is going? What is the suggestion for the next week's topic? Do you have any suggestion?
No, so that's what I don't know. What's the topic based? How do you
anything?
Decide
anything
topic?
Under the world? Anything under the world?
It should be
connected to our lives. Like if you say, let us talk about microbiology, that probably we may not do. But other things, like which is connected to our world. We had topics on concentration, we had topics on prayer, etc., etc. So, any suggestion?
Maharaj, I have one suggestion. Attachment and detachment. How to
both. Both together.
Any of one.
So, okay, detachment. Aray, detachment is very simple. No? So many equipments come, you attach and you detach. Have you not traveled ever in flight? You just seat belt, you attach, then you detach. It's so simple. Okay, done. Anybody has any objections to this topic, detachment?
No.
Okay. So, Shubhadeep, is it okay, detachment?
Yeah, fine. I was thinking the next follow-up topic with reference to today's discussion could be Mantra Diksha and qualifications of the disciple I think Byomkesh initially started the...
Okay, so what we will do is, next Sunday we will have Mantra Diksha and qualifications of a spiritual aspirant, and the next week thereafter, we will have detachment or non-attachment. Okay.
Yeah.
Okay. Yeah.
Thank you, Maharaj.
Thank you very much. Thank you.
Namaste.
Thank you, everyone.
Yeah, thank you.
Thank you.